However, to the Abraham Lincoln's credit, it must be said that we struggled on with tireless persistence. I estimated that we covered a distance of at least 500 kilometers during this ill-fated day of November the 6th. But night fell and wrapped the surging ocean in its shadows. By then, I thought our expedition had come to an end, that we would never see this fantastic animal again. I was mistaken. At 10:50 in the evening, that electric light reappeared 3 miles to windward of the frigate, just as clear and intense as the night before. The narwhal seemed motionless. It was asleep, perhaps, weary from its workday, just riding with the waves. This was our chance, and Commander Farragut was determined to take full advantage of it. He gave his orders. The Abraham Lincoln stayed at half steam, advancing cautiously so as not to awaken its adversary. In mid-ocean, it's not unusual to encounter whales so sound asleep they can successfully be attacked, and Ned Land had harpooned more than one in its slumber. The Canadian went to resume his post on the bobstays under the bowsprit. The frigate approached without making a sound, stopped 2 cable lengths from the animal, and coasted. Not a soul breathed on board. A profound silence reigned over the deck. We were not 100 feet from the blazing core of light, whose glow grew stronger and dazzled the eyes. Just then, leaning over the forecastle railings, I saw Ned Land below me, one hand grasping the martingale, the other brandishing his dreadful harpoon. Barely 20 feet separated him from the motionless animal. All at once his arm shot forward and the harpoon was launched. I heard the weapon collide resonantly as if it had hit some hard substance. The electric light suddenly went out, and 2 enormous waterspouts crashed onto the deck of the frigate, racing like a torrent from stem to stern, toppling crewmen, breaking spare masts and yardarms from their lashings.